What's going on, guys? It's your boy Adjen Bangen for another Outer Plane video. And for today, I'm gonna be sharing with you everything I know about Roxy, her playstyles, her best builds, her team builds, her strengths and weaknesses, yada yada. Just take note that these are just based on my opinions and based on my playtesting with her, so just take it with a big grain of salt. So Roxy is the newest 3-star character to be added into the game, and she is very good. Yeah, she's very, very nice. She's very fun to play with. And what makes her really fun to play? Let us take a look at her skill set. Let's digest this one by one. First, let's talk about her ultimate skill, Twin Tornado. So this one is her one of her best attacking skill. This is a cleave attack, meaning it targets all enemies in the field. And then it inflicts shock, which is a debuff that increases your damage. Yes, and then before the attack hits, it will inflict the shock debuff first before damage calculation. So meaning that this one will always hit really, really good because of the debuff inflicted by shock. Unless the opponent has an immunity buff, then the shock will not get implemented. Then the damage is come somewhat a bit underwhelming, but if the shock debuff got implemented into the opponent, then the damage for Twin Tornado is pretty decent. Yeah, it can already one shot a lot of squishy characters in the entire game, especially in PvP. Yes, and speaking of PvP, Roxy is in my honest opinion meant for PvP, unlike her twin sister Maxi, which is meant for PBE. This one is very, very good because it also has always elemental advantage, meaning it does not matter what element she is attacking with this skill tree of her, it will always have elemental advantage. And having elemental advantage means that you will deal more damage to that enemy. Yeah, plus the shock debuff, then plus the elemental advantage, this one hits pretty good. Yeah, this one is pretty, even though this one does not have some form of defense penetration like in the case of D'Aste, because usually D'Aste has the defense penetration on the skill tree. Even though this one does not have defense penetration on skill tree, this one is already one of the best cleave attack in the entire game, in my honest opinion. Very, very nice, very, very strong, and even a 3-star. As you can see, my Roxy is already rocking with 6,000 attack. You can obtain this one by having by maxing out your quirks, maxing the mage quirk and also the blue elemental quirks. Very, very easy to achieve. Her skill 2, Help Misses, this one is a passive effect, also a triggered effect. So when an ally ranger attacks, activates an additional attack on the enemy with the highest speed. After attacking, increases priority of the caster by 40% and grants increased effectiveness to allied mages and rangers for 2 turns. Some of you might be thinking that this one is a bit meh, while I might agree to that one because the only advantage that I like about this one is the increased priority 40%. This means that you don't really need to gear Roxy with lots of speed for her to be taking the turn really that fast. The increased effectiveness to allied mages and rangers for 2 turns are somewhat meh. Effectiveness is pretty much very negligible stats in the entire game. You only need this one to land debuffs, but since you're already using the skill trippers before this one, or maybe it has some form of effect on Roxy because you will be able to activate the skill 2 first before the skill 3. So that skill 2 will, the effectiveness increase will complement Roxy's skill 3 because to inflict the shock debuff to the enemy. Yeah, so it complements each other well. Her skill 1, single target attack that has a 50% chance to inflict shock for 2 turns. Damage dealt increases when the caster is granted a buff. Usually, you don't really need to use this one because by the time you've already used up that your turn with the skill tree, all enemies are already dead. All enemies are already dead, or you are already dead. It's either of the two. So this one does not really play that much importance in my honest opinion. This one is your pretty much standard normal attack skill. Now, what are the best builds for Roxy? I built her with some DPS gears and some immunity. This one is built for PvP, by the way. Yeah, because I find Roxy best suited for PvP rather than in PvE. In PvE, you can just gear whatever you want depending on the content that you're trying to tackle. But in PvP, I think this one is the best build for her since you don't want to be changing gears that much, right? So this one is the general build for my general build for her. A DPS weapon here increases damage by 10% of the target's attack when attacking. Thumping Knuckle Dusters, of course, use the usual stats. Main attack, attack percent. The substats, critical damage, critical rate. And then some speed for more for taking the turns a bit faster. Necklace is a user speed main stat here so that she will be able to get the turn. Attack, crit chance, crit damage. And then augmentation set. Why augmentation set? She will always have a buff since I will be pairing augmentation set with the immunity set. So since you have the immunity buff from the augmentation set, you always have a buff and you always have the passive effect of the augmentation set to be always active during the turn when you will be able to launch the cleave attack, your skill tree. Immunity, why immunity set? Because there are a lot of Monad Abas in our server. So 6-star Monad Aba can cap block Roxy's skill too. That is why I'm gearing her with immunity set. Because this one, if you get cap blocked by this one, if you cannot trigger this one, you might need some a little bit more speed. The 40% priority increase is already a pretty huge boost so that Roxy will be able to take the turn really, really fast. And I wanted to avoid that one. And if you take a look at my speed is only at around 226. This one is pretty good enough for me to be able to take the turn to overtake any other fast characters on my opponent's side. But if you get cock blocked by 6-star Monad Aba, the preemptive seal, you will not be able to activate this one because of that seal skill. Now let's talk about team building for Roxy. Let's go around here so that I can explain a bit further. 5 wins, 3 losses for my defense. Very, very nice. If you're somewhat this is my defense. I'm using Roxy here in my defense. And this is the team that I'm going to be suggesting for Roxy. D-Blada is essential and then Nautia is essential also. These two pair combination is very, very OP. As even though we have Monad Aba now, they're still somewhat very, very strong. Even though you can... Demi-Blada can get cock blocked by the seal skill by Monad Aba. Since she will strip the buffs of all enemies, that is already considered a debuff. And once you've inflicted debuff, Nautia will be able to launch her skill too, which is a trigger effect. This one, the sweep support. As you can see, trigger effect activates Crystal Storm and an ally lands a debuff on their turn. And if a ranger triggers a skill, Roxy will be able to launch the skill too. Yeah. So, it's a really, really good combination overall. Demi-Blada will strip the buffs. Nautia will activate her skill too. Roxy will activate her skill too. And then Cannon will activate her skill too, targeting the highest attacker. which is probably going to be an instant kill. And then Roxy will get pushed the priority, so Roxy will take the turn, and then it's just GG. The only problem to this kind of team is that, one, if you get outsped by the enemy, especially if the enemy outsped your Demiblada, it's over for you because a lot of your characters are very, very squishy. And also, if the enemy has an enemy cannon. Why? Because enemy cannon will target Roxy, and Roxy has the highest attack. Roxy will just get one-shotted by cannon. Let us test out this type of team building. Let me find someone that does not have cannon. This one does not have cannon, but I got outsped by Demiblada there. But it has melee, right? It has cannon. It has cannon, man. I wanted to fight someone that does not have cannon. Impossible. Why? Because everyone has cannon. Everyone has cannon, and we will just die. We will just die. Or you can always make a to counter cannon, you need to replace cannon with someone like this. Yes, because this one, Regina will be the one to get attack. Regina will be the one to get attack, and we can test that one out. We can test that one out, but the problem is the enemy has a Distella, which is another big problem. But let us see if we can deal with something with this one. Let me just show you how the team works. Will you be able to deal with that one? I don't think so, but let us see. This time I can just bait this cannon here to attack my Regina, and Regina has some form of survivability against the first attack. We will be avoiding the death of Roxy here. She will not get attacked by cannon. Okay, so the idea, we will strip all of these buffs here. Strip. Okay. She did not crit, which is sad. No, survive. Okay, we survive. Let us see the damage. At least I survived that one. Shock, and then boom. Okay, we one-shotted the that one, but I'm not sure if we can okay. Okay, boys, we're winning this one. We are winning this one, man. Okay, there you go, we won that fight, even though that revenge from Distella is very, very strong. Yeah, even though Roxy is very fun to play with, as you can see, Roxy has a lot of counters for you to be able to consider. One is cannon. If she's the highest attacker in the game, she will be targeted by cannon. And two, since you are inflicting some debuffs to the enemy with Notia and then Demiblada, although the strip debuff from Demiblada is uncounterable, it will not activate the agile response, the enemy can still use Distella for revenge. And revenge can one-shot Roxy if the Distella opponent is very, very strong, is built really, really strong. So yeah, there are a lot of instances where Roxy is easily countered, but As you can see, Roxy is very fun to play with. There are a lot of team buildings for her. What if you don't have Demi Blada and Notia? If you don't have Demi Blada, you can always have the stripper Alice. Wait, that sounds bad, right? That sounds bad. Where's my Alice? You can just use Alice here. Alice can also strip buffs and also do unbuffable. And then the other replacement for Notia is something like Charlotte. Since if you activate an AoE attack skill, Charlotte will trigger their skill 2 effect. And then not only it will trigger Roxy's skill 2, it will also push Roxy for another 20%, 25% priority increase, and also increasing her attack, which is good. But I prefer some damage, like the DPS character like Notia, to inflict more damage to the enemy. So yeah, those are your options for team building. For the last part, it's going to be a Plex. You can either put in Gnosis Dahlia here, or even something like another Distella here, Tannon here for more DPS, and even Demidrakan here. It really depends on your own preferences, which is really good, because team building for around Roxy is really, really fun. And I think Roxy, get one copy of her. She's really fun to use. She's also very, very strong in PvP, and I think she's worth it. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. And I think that's it for me for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please leave a like and subscribe. I would really appreciate it if you could help me grow my channel more. And thank you to everyone who are supporting my channel. I appreciate every one of you. Until next time, peace.